my friend. Welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited, yes. So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes, and terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other. This is the card you found. The fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom. Or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more if you'd like me to. No? Shame. Though I suppose it's your decision to make. And really, that's the whole point, isn't it? There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover, on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
And you never know. The universe has a kind of way of working these things out.
The universe?
Yeah, like the cosmic space gods.
Space gods.
You heard me?
Okay, spell it.
It's nothing to spell. You know, we're cool.
Oh, so cool.
We are super cool.
So she dumped her ass, huh?
Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before,
yeah,
right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Beat a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Doesn't kill you will make you stronger. Not in the mood, sign. Hey, what are you listening to? Good to know.
Is that the black guy? We got a black guy in this movie, in this game. What was that noise? Don't be clumsy. You done with it? Good job.
Jake, bags, focus.
Ah, fuck! Ah, fuck you, you spider fuck!
Yeah, you better run.
All that cussing. We're gonna squash you, bud. Huh? Slow boy. Put your butt up in.
Hey, are you guys gonna help the bags or what?
I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan,
broken.
Come on. Dylan, please.
I can't. It's
I gotta get the last bags in there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan,
closing.
Please.
Sorry, bro.
Cool, thanks guys. Skill. Ugh. Horror. I hate horror. Okay, really, dude? Locking me out?
Okay, in my defense, A, it was Dylan's idea, and two, it was really funny.
Oh, yeah, right. Is that right?
I don't write the rules, man.
Okay, whatever. Look, are you gonna help me with the bags or what?
Nah, I gotta stay here and wait for Mr. H to return our cell phone. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Okay, and why are the stairs blocked?
Well, apparently it's to keep raccoons and other pesky varmints from ransacking the place. Mr. H's words, not mine.
Oh! Boring! And this place needs a serious overhaul.
Oh. Jesus.
All right, got the bags.
Great, all by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my God, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Oh, okay, so now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake. Oh, sorry, I just got so distracted about that rhyme, I forgot what we were...
Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Ah, sexy, huh?
Hottest at camp, by far.
Okay, sure.
Look, it was all settled by the girls in bunk 7, like, second day of camp. It goes Ryan... Me, of course. Then Dylan, Emma, Abby.
Okay.
Nick, and then Mr. H, and...
Okay, are you almost finished? Please?
Yep, that's it. That's everyone. So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we gonna make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know, maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob...
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
No, but I mean, seriously, come on, she's right. It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was gonna happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house, kid, affair... Kid, divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation lawsuit, surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement, grandkid, nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind in the ballpark? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says... Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all men list.
Well, that seems legit. Okay, so are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up. Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was, like, a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out. You're right back tomorrow. No harm, no foul.
Up here, my dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't. Oh, ick! Boom. Oh. There it is.
Oh, ooh. Man, good sight.
Freak.
Oh.
Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. Surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Back off, dipshit.
I'm sorry. Peace and love, man. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Y'all ready to bounce?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah. Keep dreaming, Junior.
Beat you up.
Hey there, party bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top. Oh, too slow.
Really? Oh boy, you're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Door's locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. Then by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Are you serious? That's called breaking and entering.
No, that's called retrieving our lawfully owned possessions.
Why don't we just find Mr. Hackett and have him open it back up?
Abby, come on. Our stuff is like 3 feet away.
Sorry. No. No. As soon as we get back to Lodge, we'll find Mr. Hackett and have him help us get our bags.
Fine.
Okay, well, fine. I'm just gonna do a quick sweep then, make sure we didn't forget anything.
Knock yourself out. I don't care what Emma thinks.